Hi, I'm Indy.
I'm Shane.
I'm Giovanni.
And welcome back to Wildcat Weekly.
Yo, what is up, you guys, and welcome back to the vlog. Today I'm here with the cast of Chicago, and it's opening night. It's at intermission, you know. We're gonna go around and say hi to the cast. Today I'm here with Brianna Mosley. She's playing Velma Kelly. How do you feel about the show? I'm like David Dobrik. I talk really fast. Like this video is sponsored by SeatGeek. SeatGeek helps you make
uncomfortable yet.
SeatGeek helps you buy tickets in literally the easiest way possible. Just use code Wildcats. Brianna, you're ruining my SeatGeek promo. This is a microphone, not an ice cream cone. The beautiful.
This is my wife. I love her.
Nice. That was Olivia Culp. She's a senior. She runs cross country. This is Daniel Bloom.
Blum.
Sorry. He's playing Billy Flynn.
I'm eating a cookie right now. It's pretty good. Bad for my voice, though.
That's Thomas. He yelled at me because I ordered garlic parmesan wings instead of buffalo. You know what? It's fine. They actually were really bad. I should have gotten buffalo, but he doesn't need to know that. Last year, they redid the backstage area, so now it's an actual backstage area. So, come right this way. This is the couch that we enjoy taking naps on. I want pizza. Jenna, can you hear me? Didn't know there were subs.
Welcome back to Wildcat with you guys, and today we're going to be talking about the new AirPod Pros. But the pros are like they can cancel out sound, and I don't know how I feel about that because I like to hear my surroundings. I don't know if I'm the only one, but music does not need to blast in my ear. Like, it can be loud, but it does not need to blast in my ear to the point where I can't hear anything, because what if something's going on and I need to know? But you could also like turn it to where you can hear stuff too, so I guess that's fine too. They have like little customized things on there where I'll have to like show a picture because I can't really explain it, but a lot of like Beats have them, and they're just to like fit in your ear, because some people ears different sizes, so they're, you know, can't fit in certain headphones. But yeah, they come in three sizes. They help they help keep the AirPods in place too, like, because sometimes they fall out, which can be very annoying. You can like feel them slipping out, but I guess apparently these, they stay in regardless. And they're shorter than the ones like these. They're shorter, like very, very little. I feel like I will lose them. And their case is like so big, like their case is like this big. I feel like that's a bit much. Yeah, and they're more expensive. They're like almost $300 for headphones. Technology is taking over the world, as it should not.
Oh my goodness, we're like the robots. We're gonna have robots in the future. Like, instead of having teachers, we're gonna have robots. That'd be scary though. Just like your robot has a malfunction in class, over. I would love that. That's crazy. Oh my goodness, that is something different. I'm gonna be alive that long. They have flying cars. Oh my goodness, let me be a flying car. I promise you. I'm going to be a car day, and I'm going to get a flying car. Like, oh, what's that? We call me the Robinsons? Oh my goodness.
Anyways, back to AirPods. I am getting distracted. Okay, no, because I seen this meme and they were talking about the new AirPods and they were like, we didn't ask for a blow dryer headphone. We asked for black AirPods. I kind of feel like black AirPods is like black forces. If you don't know, then you won't get it. But that is the end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed my little rant / review. And I'll see you guys soon.
So you go to the football game on Friday?
Yes, I did.
How'd you like it?
It was good.
Pretty close game, though, wasn't it?
Yeah, unfortunately, we lost.
Yeah, that was a bummer. But, hey, at least we made it this far. Yes. New record.
We'll be better next year.
Oh, yeah, we will. So, Andy, did you hear about that new 428 Athletics?
Yes, I did. We actually took a trip down there last week.
How is it?
It's really fun. They got this really cool virtual sports place. They have the golf simulator. They have the VR there.
I heard about the VR. I heard it's fun.
Yeah, it's fun. And it also allows for really funny videos of people trying to play video games.
Oh, that sounds awesome. Can't wait to see it.
Hey guys, I'm Tony Kleinbert and I'm the president of Interact Club. What Interact Club is a volunteer service organization where we do like multiple events all around the community. You can pick and choose your events, and these events range from leaf raking, Halloween parties, nursing homes, pancake breakfasts, many others.
I joined Interact Club because I like to find out what's going on in the community and be able to volunteer and help people.
Yeah, I joined Interact Club because I wanted to help the community and get volunteer hours for college, as well as just to have something to do with my spare time.
I heard all the cool kids were in Interact Club, that's why I joined, and I love it. Best decision ever. Plus, look what we get at meetings. Hello!
Hey guys, it's Amia, and with the weather changing, so are the outfits. So let's go see what people are wearing. Okay, can you tell me what you're wearing today?
Sure I can. I'm wearing a fashionable top from Costco. My lovely pants are from Steinmart. My tennis shoes are from Kohl's. I bought those so I can do a lot of walking here at school.
Okay, I like it. Okay, officer, can you tell us what you're wearing today?
My standard police issue uniform.
Okay, can you tell us what you're wearing today?
So I have on my pilgrim shirt. Okay, I got it from Plato's Closet, and I have my jeans from City Trends, and I got my Fila's from Journeys.
What are you wearing, Jake from State Farm?
Khakis.
She sounds hideous.
Well, she's a guy.
Okay, can you tell us what you're wearing today?
I'm wearing a hoodie, some jogger pants, and some Uggs. Is this a snow day? Well, it should be.
Okay, Kendall, can you tell us what you're wearing today?
I got on this coat from H&M. I got on these leggings from Fashion Nova. I got on my Uggs and a regular Champion hoodie.
Okay. Okay, can you tell us what you're wearing today?
A blouse, a pair of pants, and a pair of boots.
Okay, where'd you get it from?
Boots I've had at least 15 years. I can't remember. And the only reason I have them on is because I forgot my tennis shoes at home and I'm sweating. The pants, I know they're from Target. The top is either Marshalls or Marshalls or TJ Maxx, one of the two.
Okay, thank you. Okay, I'm wearing a necklace from Forever 21, you know, and then I got my Adidas, you know, sweatpants on with the Uggs and, you know, winter vibes, you feel me? Yeah.
Hey G, so how's basketball going for you?
It's going very good. Our first home game is December 13th against North.
Is the team looking good this year?
Very good. We're looking better than ever.
Gonna win everything. They're gonna go undefeated. Yeah.
So, Andy, what are you gonna do over break?
Well, we're gonna have some nice turkey dinner on Thanksgiving.
Okay, you gonna do some Black Friday shopping?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
How about them segments coming up, though?
Yeah. Next week, we have a special Wildcat Weekly Thanksgiving edition episode coming up.
Enjoy.
Hey, guys, I'm Annabelle.
I'm Katie.
I'm Monica, and today we're going to go around the school and find a teacher that will learn a TikTok.
So let's get started.
Let's see if they do it right.
Like Superman trainer, ay. Real rare like Super Saiyan manga. I stomp on Lucifer Sage. Now I got a few rings on Jupiter skating. I meant to say,
it's like a clock that was TikTok.
Okay, it's like an app where you like dance.
Do you want to learn?
Oh, it's what? Yeah. You like dance for 10 seconds or something? Yeah.
Okay.
Like Superman trainer, ay. Real rare like Super Saiyan manga. I stomp on Lucifer Sage. Now I got a few rings on Jupiter skating. I meant to say. Like Superman trainer, ay. Real rare like Super Saiyan manga. I stomp on Lucifer Sage. Now I got a few rings on Jupiter skating. I meant to say.
Snow has been spotted.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
What do you think about the snow?
You know, people are mad that everyone's trying to celebrate Christmas a little bit early, but I'm all here for it.
I am excited that we are going to have a white Thanksgiving. Thank you.
Look at Becca's socks.
Not for the game.
Look at Becca is ready for Christmas.
Becca's Christmas socks. Cat Weekly, we have to walk to the Innovation Center.
And it's snowing.
Ready, go!
Take all the umbrellas! So selfish, look at that! What is this? Thanks, I know. You can't talk yet. How do you feel about the snow?
I love it. I wish I was home cleaning and putting up a Christmas tree, like baking something fun like that.
She's ready for Christmas.
Yeah. No, really, it would be so much fun to be home in your pajamas, have the fireplace on, having something baking, cooking, that beautiful smell. Can you get it? The white picket fence?
That's all. I know, I have snow in my hair. This is really great. Yes.
You ready?
It's not about snow days, is it?
No, it's not about snow days. However, if we get snow days this year...
Yeah, we have at least 15 snow days.
At least 15. This is going on record.
Absolutely.
This is on 15 snow days on the record.
Maybe 20. Fast.
Ooh, maybe 20.
25. Just for you guys. Absolutely.
All right.
Fight song in different languages.
Vamanos.
Llevar la pelota por el campo, touchdown seguro es la base. Ra, ra, ra!
Sue Mayfield, combate per tua fama.
Так что борись, ребята, бороться, и мы выиграем эту игру.
Do you know all of these languages?
Hope so. Arrivederci, buona giornata.
So, G, what are you looking forward to doing this weekend?
I'm looking forward to going to the Browns game.
Oh. Who are they playing this weekend?
The Miami Dolphins. How about you?
I'm looking forward to the Browns helping my fantasy team. I got Odell Beckham and I got Nick Chubb. So I hope that they both perform really well this weekend.
Yes, let's hope they do so we get this win.
Let's go. Let's go, Browns.
Yes.
Woo!
Welcome back to Fantasy Football Updates.
Dak Prescott had 444 passing yards and 3 passing touchdowns against the Detroit Lions this week.
Lamar Jackson had 222 passing yards with 4 passing touchdowns, as well as 79 rushing yards. He's been on a tear this year. Let's see if he wins MVP. DJ Chark had 8 receptions for 104 yards and 2 touchdowns. He's been very reliable this year.
Calvin Ridley had 8 receptions for 143 yards and 1 touchdown against the Carolina Panthers.
This Thanksgiving, the Bears and the Lions play. Kenny Galladay, a wide receiver on the Detroit Lions, is someone you got to watch out for this Thanksgiving. The Falcons and the Saints also play each other on Thanksgiving. Last year, the Saints were able to hold back the Falcons with their good defense. Let's see if they can do it again this year.
The last game is the Cowboys versus the Bills. Watch out for Zeke. He should do really well this week.
Hey, it's Madison Farrell, and I had a chance to interview the coach and some of the basketball players. Check it out. Who's the greatest of all time, Jordan or James?
Oh, definitely James. He's got it on lock.
Can you dunk a ball?
Here and there on a good day. On a good day, I can.
Who's your favorite basketball player?
LeBron James.
Who's the greatest of all time, Jordan or James?
Jordan.
Can you dunk a ball?
No.
Who's your favorite player?
NBA, probably Jetty Osman.
What are you excited for this season?
I'm excited to get out there. We don't really have any expectations, so we're kind of just going to open-minded, and we're just trying to have fun this year.
Okay. What are your goals for this season?
My goal for the season is to win the conference, number one, and then take it from there.
Okay. Who's your favorite basketball player?
My favorite basketball player is definitely LeBron James.
Okay. Who's your favorite basketball player?
LeBron James.
What are you excited for this season?
Just another year playing with our friends and just doing what we love to do.
What are your goals for this season?
Win the conference. That's pretty much it.
Okay. What's your goal for this season?
Goal for this season is to win our conference. We want to be competitive in every game that we play, and our guys know that they're going to be prepared to win every game. Whether we do or not, it's going to be entirely how the game flows. But that's kind of our goal.
Is there a team that you're looking forward to playing?
Not really. You know, we're an 8-team conference. Every game is a big game as far as I'm concerned. So, you know, there's no rivalry as far as I'm concerned. All 7 other opponents are opponents that we're looking forward to playing.
Okay. What's your coaching philosophy?
Play hard. we're an easy team to play for. I want our guys to play hard. We basically play man-to-man, and I expect them to know how to, you know, the different rules that we follow, playing man-to-man. And we run a real open-style offense, and it's a fun offense to watch.
Hey guys, welcome back to Mayfield Minute. So we have a special guest today, Monica DeFranco.
Hey guys.
Okay, so we're going to be looking at tweets. And we'll start off with Keith Kelly posted, "Very proud of our football team. Thank you for your grit, determination, talent, and courage. It was so cold watching. Oh, so cool watching you compete with heart and soul. Your tenacity upheld the Mayfield way. This team will go down in history. Good job, boys. You had a great season. We'll get Hoban next year."
Mr. DeCina tweeted, "Who is ready to rock out some learning?" And he posted some pictures of the new upper gym as a learning space. So that's like a new cool area for them.
Okay, then Mrs. K. Rotino posted, "Crazy hat and hair day at center today for Red Ribbon Week. That was last week, but that's so fun, and I remember when I did that in elementary school, and it's so fun. So, and everyone looked so cute."
Keith Kelly tweeted, "Congratulations to the cast, crew, orchestra, directors, parent boosters, all involved in the spectacular production of Chicago. Can't wait for the spring production. Chicago was this past weekend, heard it was great, so everyone in it, good job."
Yeah. Okay, we're done.
This has been another episode of Wildcat Weekly.
Make sure to look forward to the Thanksgiving episode next week.
Stay tuned.